A warm good morning to all of you. Thank you. I expected the reply. I welcome each one of you on behalf of DNS ERP Private Limited for this August seminar. I would like to call upon Mr. S. Mohan to explain to concept ERP concept. His background is, first of all, he is the director of DNS ERP Private Limited. He is BCom, CAIIB, ICWA, 27 years experience in corporate finance, venture capital. His area of specialization is project appraisal, which includes project finance, reconstructing, monitoring of small, medium and large scale industry. He has been the architect in the evolution of DNS ERP software since the start. Formerly with IDBI Limited, he is the founder director of DNS ERP Private Limited, as I said. Sir?
Good morning. Good morning. That's fine. Okay. It's indeed a privilege and a pleasure to welcome you all. And we in DNS, we have always believed that it's always a team effort. And people like Mr. Janakiraman, with his experience in ERP, has guided us to such an extent that we can very proudly say that there are certain very key modules in ERP which many a company have not been able to interlink and give the linkages like we have been able to give in the DNS. And one example he has already given, like the bill of material. The second is when you do a subcontracting, the 4-5A challan automatically getting generated from the system, so on and so forth. I mean, I can go on, but the point is that these are very key areas. It hasn't come easily, it hasn't come overnight. It's taken a lot of pain and effort, and today we have a full-fledged ERP. What we are going to do in the next three and a half hours is go through a journey of bringing before you the concept of ERP. Okay. Now, it makes very little difference whether you are a manufacturer, you are a trader, you are an education institution, or you are running a hospital. At the end of the day, a lot of procedures and processes are the same. For a manufacturer, a buyer may be a customer, but for an educational institution, the student is akin to a customer. Okay. So what we are going to do is we are going to give the linkages right from the beginning up to the end in the ERP system. And with specifics, with our experience of handling so many projects, we'll give you actual live examples of how a particular problem or a process is handled in an organization. Right? Okay? Get started. Why do we need an ERP at all? This question begs the thought in the minds of everybody. Why do we need an ERP? We need an ERP because in some form or the other, we have islands of information. Okay? But they don't talk to each other. We need a system where various processes, be it purchase, be it stores, be it production, be it sales, are linked to each other. Because the function of ERP is give you the picture in its entirety for an organization. Imagine in a multi-user organization where somebody is sitting somewhere and making a purchase order and the material is received at the factory elsewhere. So how do you make out in layman's terms ki maine kya order kiya tha aur kya material aaya? Right? So this fully integrated business management software will enable you to manage your business seamlessly, effortlessly, okay, and more importantly, on a real-time basis. Next. Like I said, we have islands of information. Maybe we have some software for production. We have something for inventory. We have tally for accounts. We have some CRM packages and so on and so forth. But they don't talk to each other. With the result, what happens is that duplication of entries. And when you have duplication of entries, the chances of errors are high. We want to eliminate that. We can't afford to have that. Right? Next. So this answers why we need an ERP. Next. As I said, there are multi-users. It's a client-server architecture. You have a server, and then clients or the nodes machines, the people are entering data or retrieving data, not from their individual machines, but from the server. I'll give you an example. Like say, for example, you are dealing with Tata Motors. Okay, and the person who's handling purchases is not there for 2 days. You want to contact somebody. A very simple example I'm taking. You want to contact somebody in Tata Motors. The guy has locked his drawer and gone over to Mahabaleshwar for 2 days vacation. What do? You run helter skelter to find the person because it needs to be addressed immediately. In the system, in the customer master, you will know purchase department, Tata Motors. Again, there are 10 Kulkarnis there. Which Kulkarni to contact? So that the Kulkarni whom you have to contact is available in your master with his mobile number, telephone, email ID, everything. And this system is available to anybody and everybody in the organization. Because the data is not stored on the individual's machine, the data is stored on the server, right? Going forward, I will discuss about database backup and how to take care of all that. But the point is that when we are talking about a client-server architecture, it doesn't matter whether A is available or not available. The system takes care of itself. In very simple words, we are making the system persona non-dependent, right? Next. This is a very simple but an effective definition of ERP. Like I said, it's a fully integrated business management software. It links business processes automatically across various departments. You get real-time information. You want to know at 10:10 what is the stock that is available to me right now. Okay. Authorized user, very important. Why should the purchase guy know at what rate you are selling and vice versa? So through a role and responsibility matrix, we assign what menu he can even open and see, leave alone making entries, okay? Going forward, I'll explain in detail how it's done. Thus, it helps in decision making. Because most of the time what happens in an organization that we get bogged down with a lot of mundane activity. We want to free our time for strategizing our business and improve our business, right? The system is going to help you. Next. I think this is self-explanatory. There are some very, very small features, but it helps an organization in a